This is just a quick way to make sure your tensioner on these Volvo S60s are set properly. Don't forget the center bolt is only 15 Newton meter or 20 feet pounds, so it's not a big torque. The needle needs to stay right in the center, as you see there, when the weather outside is 15 degrees, 20 Celsius, and the engine is cold. So that's the setup. As you warm it warms up, the needle will move to the right. As it cools down, especially in winter days, will move to the left. Very easy, just depress the center here on the belt and see how the needle moves to the right side. So I'm depressing like this, and as I keep it depressed, the needle moves to the right side, and as I release it, it goes to the left. So let's see, like this, it needs to go back there. Another thing is, you should not have it shaking, wobbling with the engine running. It really needs to stay very stable. Next, the belt needs to stay really more or less centered, but you notice how it is. It's perhaps slightly to the left, but really needs to stay above the center. If you see, the belt is running like this on the side, is a problem with the tensioner. It does, something is not okay. Also, when the engine is running, if you see the belt moving left to right a little bit, another problem with the tensioner. So those are a little bit of checks. Use only quality parts, don't skip on this one, really don't. Timing belt kits I would recommend are Continental, and the belt will be ContiTech. That's the brand that makes it for Volvo. The tensioners, some people have problems setting the INAP tensioners, so it's better perhaps grab a Volvo one, or I don't remember exactly the brand. I think maybe Gates makes them better, I don't know, but sometimes it's really hard to adjust them, especially you put the needle there and then when you tie the bolt, the needle will move to the right. So better just put the needle a little bit to the left, and when you tie the bolt down, the needle will just adjust itself into the center. Water pump, we don't need to replace it with the first timing belt at 100,000 miles. Even the most Volvo dealers will only replace the genuine original one at 200,000 miles, about 300,000 kilometers. That's because the original one is very, very solid, barely fails, and it's last almost the life of the car. But very, very aware for the aftermarket ones, use only Aisin. That's who makes it for Volvo, the genuine one. Check online sites, FCP Euro, IPD USA, or even eBay. Never put an aftermarket cheap brand or non-branded pump, water pump. It will fail all of a sudden from 6 months, 2 years, will just jump the engine, and your engine top is going to be broken, and you lose your engine and perhaps your car as well. So only Aisin, only Continental, maybe Gates, who knows. I don't know, sometimes they change the components or the roller here, the tensioner, but it really, Continental is the best choice. Never touch on Daiko belts or items, don't touch Daiko. Speaking of the water pump, it has 7 bolts, all hidden all around, so it's 7 of them, and they are really tough to reach. The best will be to use an extension, but the 3-inch standard one just doesn't fit in there. So if you have a smaller extension, maybe 1 or 2 inch one, otherwise just with the ratchet with the socket 10 millimeter, it's going to be very long to remove them from there. And the last tip, when you purchase a car and maybe you check the belt or check the bills and notice the guy did replace everything, timing belt, perhaps water pump, always check the brand. Check if it did replace the water pump with a cheap one, because many mechanics do so, and every single time you hear a guy with a Volvo saying the water pump failed and took my engine down and I need a new engine, it was an aftermarket cheap one that lasted maybe 1 year, 2 years, even less. So one last tip, you are going to just see check a Volvo S60 that's on sale, you want to purchase it, want to check the timing belt, it's very easy, just clip, unclip this metal clip, pop a little bit this cover, and then just pry on the side cover like this on the sides, and you get a view of the timing belt that's inside. Check it out for cracks. Remember that even the original ones at 100,000 miles, they are not really crack around, but it gives you a quick idea, and you don't have to remove anything else.